Hi, I'm Mary Poplin from Boris Effects.
And I am Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects.
So now that we have explored planar tracking and rotoscoping and how to export all of that data, we're going to talk about features that are found only inside of Mocha Pro. Things like the power mesh module, things like the remove module, things like the lens module, the stabilize module, etc.
And these features make powerful visual effects a lot faster and easier than they've ever been before. And we're going to be starting with Power Mesh, introduced in Mocha Pro 2021. And the Power Mesh builds on and expands the planar tracking technology that we've been looking at so far in this course.
Exactly. So we've been talking about broad planar tracking, and what we're going to talk about now is subplanar tracking. So I'm going to show you how to do warped tracks on things like faces and t-shirts, and also show you how to use it for roto. So we're going to build on what Ben showed you about roto. It's going to be a really great walkthrough on what is essentially a new feature for all of our users. So we think that you'll get a lot of use out of this section. Once we've discussed the Power Mesh module, Ben's going to take you through the Stabilize module, and I'm going to let him talk to you a little bit about what he's going to show you within the Stabilize module.
Yeah, so Stabilize is going to take some of the tools and techniques that we've already looked at. What we're going to be looking at specifically is various types of footage, why you might want to stabilize them, how you can stabilize them, and how using Mocha's Stabilize module will give you better results than just sticking on a quick auto stabilize.
And after we've taken you through the Stabilize module, Ben's going to take you through the Lens module. And the Lens module is really vital for taking warp out of your shots when you need to do tracking tasks.
Yeah, so this is one of those features that you might actually live some of your life without actually touching. But once you've seen it and seen how much more accurate your tracks, inserts, and paintwork can be, I don't think you'll be able to sort of go back and live without it.
One of my favorite things about the Lens module is that sometimes it will appear that you're not quite getting a correct track. And 9 times out of 10, if you go and look at your straight lines, they're going to be curved. And that is where the Lens module really saves you.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's one of the reasons why we're going to go a little bit deeper into the Lens module than I've been in previous tutorials. But following on from the Lens module, I'm going to hand it back over to Mary. And she's going to be taking you through the Remove module.
And the reason that most of our users love the Remove module is because what you do is you track a foreground object, you track a background object, and then you use the planar data that moves behind that object to replace the pixels of the object itself. It's an automated process. But we're going to talk about the basics of the Remove module. We're going to talk about what do you do when Mocha can't see behind the object. And we're going to do other troubleshooting and lighting matching settings to show you how to get the most out of the Remove module.
And as we've seen as well with the Stabilize module, that same idea and that same technology is shared between different Mocha Pro modules as well. And this also plays into the final part of this course, which is Mary talking about megaplates.
Exactly. Megaplates are a tool that you can use to create a constant background plate that's large format that you can use to replace things like clean plates for removes, do sky inserts, and also that will break down how to do matte paintings and things like that in your shot.
So now we've had a little overview of what we're going to do, let's get on and do it and look at our first module, which is going to be Power Mesh.